hands-free. I grew up in a trailer park, and I made something of myself. What the hell's wrong with you?
Eric, you never even saw Rachel's boobies, man. I married that chick. You know how nice those boobies are? Eric, you worthless fuck. Look at you. You should have graduated from college. Now you're just some bum on the street.
Our dad died, and look at us.
Don't you know I know that? Why?
Oh, come on, Eric.
Stop
look at you.
You're worthless.
Yeah!
All right, ladies and gentlemen, in the color of wrong place at the wrong time, Team That Guy.
Good afternoon. My name is Michael Lipkin. I am the editor-in-chief of the Chicago Times, and I have a master's degree in Buddhist philosophy with an emphasis in Eastern surgery. I'm here to introduce the renowned Dr. Nivyut Putman, who is a world-renowned researcher in optic retina, and recently has a journal that was published in the Opto-Retina Journal, and a graduate of the University of Indiana with an accredited German book entitled Hat sie doch sie. He specializes in optics, solar ophthalmology, and audio iris scanning. Everyone, please welcome Dr. Neville Widgman.
We were in the room, we were present.
We're always with him, like nonstop, except right now.
For all the reasons, we were the ones there.
We said, good job. And so we are about to explain his whole concept.
Yeah, jeez.
So,
20 minutes.
Let's,
20
let's,
minutes is how much time
yeah,
we have.
That's right.
Wow, there's just so much stuff, I just don't know how we can talk about it all.
Pupil. The first part, yeah.
We've got pupils in our eyes.
From the first are similar. And then you go all the way in the back and it's like...
What was that one experiment he did when, you know, he started with the front of the eye and then he worked his way back.
Yeah.
And he was using like...
was called monotronics.
Monotronics.
Right.
Where he obviously had the lizard.
The lizard! Oh my god! Yeah! And then the lizard...
I was like,
Okay. We're a little short on time. Why don't we just have a quick Q&A, okay?
Yeah, that's right, because then we'll get what you don't know.
Yeah.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Hi there, hey guys.
Stand up, please.
Sure. Hi, I'm Jerry. I actually attend the University of California, Irvine. Okay, all right. I just wanted to tell you guys like how big of an impact you've had on the entire optic community. You know, yeah, I seriously you inspired a whole generation.
Relay the message, yeah.
Okay, all right. So I wrote down my question. So now my question relates to the article that was just published. In it, you stated that when a pupil becomes dilated to the point of maximum volume, the cone and rod matrices shall induce a positive optic diffusion if given the right parameters. Do you feel the assertion as significant, or do you find it inconclusive?
Yes. Next question.
All right. Well, related to this point, could you explain the equation used to derive the conclusion? Omega equals pi sigma delta I minus delta I squared over the square root of omega times the second?
Not right here.
Oh, perfect.
This isn't right.
Yeah.
And that's a circle. So how it starts is first you look at it, and then you break it down. There's that part, you look at this part, and then
why don't we explain this better through rap?
Okay, I think that's all the time we have. All right.
Thanks, guys. Thanks so much.
Frank and Edward. So in this game, the players are going to do
This is Time Sleep After Morning.
Jimmy, dark days indeed.
Ever since the Wall Street crash, we've just been on the streets lighting fires for warmth.
I second that. Wall Street is up and it's always gonna be a
holiday. Hell yeah. Pockets are just lined with cash. I just burn it for fun.
Oh, that was just a 20. Let's try 100.
Jeffrey, it's times like this I'm glad I have you as a business partner.
I know. Remember how shitty it was when I wasn't even around?
Oh my god. I just had a friend to make money with.
excuse me, sir. Do you have the time for chance?
It's time to get rich. What's your name?
It's like the Great Depression never happened. It's like wealth is everywhere and it's just ours.
It did not. We invented that time machine and rewrote history the way we saw fit.
You're right. We did that the day we first met, right after I got your name.
Time slip!
Charlie, was it? Charlie.
Yeah, Charlie. Nice to meet you. Was it Jeffrey? I don't know my name sometimes. I confuse it with places and things like that.
Really? I've got half a time machine here. I've been working on it for a little while.
You have half a time.
Half a time machine. Is it the other half?
It would appear so.
Yay!
Yay for history! Now, we're going to play a game called Parallel Universe. Anybody want to play Parallel Universe?
Yeah.
Oh, awesome. Great. So, how Parallel Universe works, okay? I'm gonna get two locations from you guys, okay? And they're gonna do a scene in both of those locations at the same time. But obviously we're human beings, so we can't visually comprehend both of them at once. So they're gonna start out the scene in one location, and then when I yell Parallel Universe, they're gonna go into the other location. All right, you guys ready to see that?
Yes.
So I need a suggestion from you guys. And I have Uranus.
Brown,
you know?
I
Fine.
Okay. Hey, that sounds like a great idea. Look, Hamburger Place in Taiwan. Wow!
Parallel universe.
I'm gonna stay right here until you figure out all of Taiwan.
And figure it all out?
Together.
Excuses to touch people's clothes. I enjoy that one too, audience member. Belly dance like a genie.
Okay.
Very fitting of our theme, thank you. That was creative. Burst into tears whenever scene partner starts to move. A demon cat is trying to kill you.
Oh no.
This is my personal favorite. Beware. Kiss someone in the front row.
Yeah.
You're my police! It's arson, and that's how it works out.
Yeah. You can blame anything.
All right, mates, the first meeting of the jousting club shall commence in moments. All right, we have our lances, and our jousts, and our steeds. We have one steed here, two steeds here.
That one seems to work out pretty well.
Tim's on the other, please.
Damn, that was mine. Very well then, my jousting shall be made. Count your steed. Alright, this shall be my steed. Run on.
Chronic ear infection. It's been on for a week.
Oh, damn you! Well, we can at least use the padded lances today. Did you bring your pad? You did not bring your padded lances. You know that will impale someone and murder them.
Yes, I thought that was the point of the jousting tournament.
It is a jousting club tournament.
Your lances with clubs, instead of lances.
Okay, so I think it's better off if we don't commit arson and we donate the link to a worthy cause, you know?
Yeah. Excuse me, we have a laundry room reserved for...
You know, it's been
be careful there.
Sorry, it's been a day. Now, how much are the mangoes?
We got chino, we got tamarindo.
This was my late husband's favorite kind of mango. I think I'll...
Exactly!
I'll play it right here.
Where are you? Come on, get out of here!
Excuse me! You like your language and the brave of my husband!
I disagree!
Change the world. Can I get some suggestions?
Step into Harvard.
Broke your nose with your locker.
Come on, give your suggestions. This is the story of the first day of band.
And I was like, cool, but how do you do that
have only five toes. And he was like, watch.
Despite Mark's intellectual shortcomings, his saxophone seemed to be above adequate. I would judge it at a C minus. Perhaps I would bump it up to a B minus if the case were taken, but I digress. Now, Mark is not only a student teacher for my math class, he also teaches Mr. Garcia's band class. Today, he was 4 minutes late. I asked him why.
And when he played it, he only played it with his toes. He literally didn't use his hands at all. And I was like, I think I'm in love with you.
Mark explained to me that he was 4 minutes late because he had sprained his big toe performing a saxophone. I told him this was completely unacceptable, and I set out to find the culprit of such a primordious digression.
And after he was done playing Ode to Joy like 100 times, I was like, where are we? This is really sketchy. We're like in the middle of nowhere. And then I look out like really far, and there's this guy standing there. And he was mouthing my name. Johanna. Johanna. Except for his class sometimes. We're gonna drop you off here. Bye!
As I stood there in my finest pantsuit, looking as beautiful as I could possibly look, I was reminded of how my husband had left me for a man. I saw this woman sitting in the bus, holding a clarinet case. I began to yell her name. She had everything. She had music. She had beauty. I did not want her to live.
I wish love. Is anyone looking me up?
And I went, shut the fuck up!
All right. When they hug, everybody goes, aww. Okay, 1, 2, 3.
Aww.
Remember that?
From, yeah.
From Full House. Like, those moments.
So we're playing a game called Full House, and we're gonna have a regular sketch, okay? Regular scene, and I can yell out Full House at any moment, and then we'll have a lovely Full House moment.
Yay.
Yeah!
Yay.
Same.
same?
The floor is similar to the roof. In the sense that it protects us from falling through to the earth.
Windows, walls.
Windows and walls are all the same part, all the same compartments. Is destruction?
Probably not.
Me and Dale, like, we both
want
to be engineers when we grow up.
Yeah, we're
but
studying.
You, yeah. We feel that explosions are just a part of our learning.
Well, I think that is true, but you have to open a book first. You can't just burn it. I saw a big pile of burned books.
Blew them all up.
Yeah, you can do a good job covering them. Yeah, they're in plain sight for everyone to see, sweetie. Yeah.
All right. Yeah, just got, you know, might as well finish the job, right? You
know. Yeah.
Sometimes I'm much
more. No, no, you say it.
The same time. Sometimes when you're feeling sad, you just have to blow stuff up.
You know me, I'm a man!
You are a man!
Yes.
I mean, we can.
So what do we think? Are we taking shirts off yet, or what are we gonna do? Clothes on?
I'm starting to feel like my e-vibe was misleading.
No, I have a copy of your e-vibe. Dear Ashley, that's me!
Even though you haven't been since like 1997.
Hey, I'm still cute and juvenile. I just happen to drink and party and get arrested a lot. Boy.
It's okay, you know what happens? Snowman.
No!
I'm sorry, that was a racial slur. You are the last person I would want to sleep with.
Oh, that's expected. That's
going to
happen right now.
Ice cream man, anyone looking for a scoop? Anyone looking for a scoop?
Son of a bitch.
You were looking for a different kind of scoop.
Yeah. Oh, I gotta get you over the head of it. It's black and white, baby. Black and white. And red all over, yes, thank you.
Why is the ice cream man still with an earshot?
He is so smart. He is so smart. Listen, you read my latest one?
No, I stopped following your blog.
Well, Barack, now, come on, blog? Come on, we're Barack Obama did it again. The Democrats taking over this country. I'm telling you something. I wrote a big article under the boss at Nix. Jonah Jameson, I wish I had him as a boss, I'll tell you that much.
I wish I had a boss at all.
Yeah, I know you do.
Oh, 1 second.
Journalism school for nothing.
Hello.
Mommy, you said you would help me with my book report.
I forgot I had you. We talked about this. You are your dad's child now.
Oh, our report, come on, please. Help me.
You know what?
Do you know anything about book reports?
I know the editor. The LA Times, he's a co-worker of mine, obviously. I'll get him in here.
You are the biggest pedophile name dropper I have ever met. Let's do something else, and I need you to say
it. You don't even know what I do for a living, huh?
No, I have no idea!
You know what? I'm not going to tell you.
I didn't think you would.
I'm never going to.
Because come on, let's go, dude. You sleazy, conniving, conundruming, other adjectives that I can't say.
You are Roy Cohn!
Very specific. I like that about you.
I know you like specifics, as you're a journalist. Hey, this is about me, right?
be one next week, and it may or may not involve prizes, so please dress up. It's basically like everyone dressed up, right?
Yeah.
No.
Because otherwise, no one dressed up.
I have hardly seen.
I see a lot of class, you know.
Here,
we have side ponytail.
It's a swim bear.
We'll be right back.